Hey everyone, you're watching K-Tronic. And in today's video, we're going to build a joystick-controlled RC car. Make sure to watch this video till the end, don't skip anything, or you might miss something important. I'll be explaining everything from the very basics, step by step, in full detail that I can say with 100% confidence. That if you stay with me till the end, you'll easily be able to make this project by yourself. And if you still have any confusion or don't understand something, feel free to ask me in the comments, or you can even DM me on Instagram. So let's get started. First of all, we're going to build the transmitter part of our joystick-controlled RC car. To begin with, take your Arduino Uno and place it onto the breadboard just like this. Use some double-sided tape to stick it securely in place. Now, grab a male-to-male jumper wire and connect the GND pin of the Arduino to the ground rail of the breadboard. Next, we'll take a joystick module, and to connect it, we'll need 4 jumper wires, female to male. Carefully plug the female ends into the joystick module's pins. And now, we'll connect the male ends to the Arduino Uno. Connect the VCC of the joystick to the 5V pin on the Arduino, the GND to GND, then, connect the VRX pin to A0, and VRE pin to A1. This will allow the Arduino to read both horizontal and vertical directions from the joystick. Here, as you can see, I have 2 different types of NRF24L01 modules. One of them comes with an antenna, while the other one is without an antenna. The version with the antenna is typically used for long-range communication, such as in drones, RC airplanes, or long-distance wireless projects. The NRF module without an antenna is ideal for short-range applications like RC cars, boats, or home automation. So for today's project, I'll be using the antenna version on the transmitter side to ensure strong signal output, and the non-antenna version on the receiver side. So now, let's go ahead and connect our NRF24L01 module to the Arduino. And while I do that, if you're enjoying the video so far, make sure to hit the like button, and if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe, your support really helps. After this video, I'll be making a complete transmitter and receiver setup using 2 joysticks and NRF modules. So if you're interested in more Arduino-based projects or want to see the next part of this build, just tap subscribe and make sure to turn on the bell notification. Now let's upload the transmitter code. You'll find the code, circuit diagram, link in the description as well as in the first pinned comment, you can download everything from there. At the very top of the code, you'll notice some lines with hashtags, these are the required libraries. First, select one of them, copy it, and go to the Tools menu. There, click on Manage Libraries. A search bar will open, paste the library name there. If you see update, it means the library is already installed. If it says install, go ahead and click it. Repeat this process for all required libraries. Once done, go to Tools again to select your board. I'm using Arduino Uno, so I'll select that. Choose your board according to your setup. After that, go back to Tools to select the correct port, then hit the upload arrow. As you can see, the code is now uploading successfully. Now our transmitter is completely ready. To power it up, I'll be using two 18,650 lithium batteries. I'll attach the battery holder to the backside of the breadboard using double tape to keep everything neat and compact. So friends, now let's start building the receiver side. First of all, we'll assemble the 2WD RC car chassis. As you can see here, this is the car's main base where we'll mount the motors, wheels, and electronics. This here is the caster wheel, and we'll attach it to the front side of the chassis. It helps the car stay balanced while moving, secure it properly using screws. This way, the car will move smoothly forward and backward. Now, let's mount the two TT motors underneath the chassis. Use screws to tightly fix both motors to the frame. Make sure the motors are aligned in such a way that both wheels rotate in the same direction. Thank you. Now you can see, I've used a hot glue gun to securely attach the L298 motor driver, Arduino Uno, and 12V battery onto the car chassis. Next, we'll start making the power connections. First, let's power the L298 motor driver. You'll see that the battery has two wires, red and black. On the L298 module, there are three terminals on the power input side, one marked 12V, GND, and 5V. Connect the red wire from the battery to the 12V terminal on the L298. Then take the black wire from the battery and connect it to GND using a male-to-male jumper wire. Now we'll provide power to the Arduino as well. From the 5V terminal of the L298, connect a jumper wire to the VIN pin on the Arduino Uno. And also connect the GND terminal of the L298 to the GND pin of the Arduino. This will ensure both the motor driver and Arduino are powered properly by the same battery. So friends, our project is now complete. But before we jump into the demo, if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please take a second to hit that subscribe button and turn on the bell notification. I regularly upload informative and exciting DIY tech projects just like this one, and I don't want you to miss any of them. Now, let's see the live demo of our joystick-controlled RC car in action. Now before we move on to the demo, let's upload the receiver code. Here too, the libraries are listed at the top, just like we did for the transmitter code. You need to install these libraries as well. After that, go to Tools again to select your board. I'm using Arduino Uno, so I'll select that. Choose your board according to your setup. After that, go back to Tools to select the correct port. Then hit the upload arrow. As you can see, the code is now uploading successfully.